Welcome, everybody. This is a day to be incredibly grateful for and incredibly excited about, most importantly, because we're launching the NBA careers of two fine young men, Bronny James and Dalton Knecht. This is day one. We're going to go from here to taking these chairs away, taking the cameras away, and having a practice. And getting ready for summer league, and that's what Dalton and Bronny are about. These are two men of high character and hard work ethic. Those are the qualities we look for at the Lakers when we draft players. And it's a testament to how Bronny was raised by LeBron and Savannah, and how Dalton was raised by Kerry and Corey. And that means a lot to us. So we're going to take some questions and then get ready to go kick some butt in summer league.
Dalton, if we could start with you, we got to see your reaction up on the stage and kind of go through that moment. What have these last couple of days been like for you and conversations with Rob or your new coach, JJ, and just that kind of building excitement as you start your NBA career?
It's been exciting, you know, meeting them in person, not only just through the phone. And it's been a fun journey because, you know, like I said earlier, my journey's been different. And coming here to a historic franchise, it's going to be fun. Can't wait to get to work.
And then to follow up with Bronny, just that moment, right, where you get the phone call and then you hear your name. Can you take us through the emotions of all of that and what you were feeling and then how you've been feeling the last couple of days since?
Yeah, everything's just been surreal. Just trying to take it all in by the days. Extremely, you know, grateful for everything that JJ and Rob have given to me. And I've just been extremely excited to get to work.
Bronny, Jim Hill, KKL9, what have been some of the preliminary conversations you've had with your father about what's expected in the NBA and what you can expect to hear and see once you start playing?
You know, we haven't gone too deep into that stuff yet, especially because we haven't even started summer league yet. But, you know, just stuff that he's been telling me my whole life, just having that work ethic and coming in and getting your work in and listening to your coaches and being coachable, stuff like that he's, you know, driven into my head my whole life.
Guys, Dan Wicky from the LA Times. A couple questions. JJ, first for you, going through your first draft, what did you like about Dalton and Bronny, and what was it like having them be the first two players that you were able to help select?
Yeah, I mean, I was thrilled to be in the draft room. It was a very amazing experience for me. We didn't think Dalton would be available at 17, but he provides something that we just don't have. You know, he's a movement shooter. He can obviously play off the bounce. We viewed him very highly on our draft board, and he can score at all three levels. He's got size. There was a lot of things to be excited about with Dalton, and I'm excited to coach him. With Bronny, I want to clarify one thing you just said, which is Rob and I did not give Bronny anything. Bronny has earned this, right? Bronny talks about his hard work. Bronny has earned this through hard work. And for us, prioritizing player development, we view Bronny as like case study one, because his base level of feel, athleticism, point of attack defender, shooting, passing, there's a lot to like about his game. And as we sort of build out our player development program holistically, he's going to have a great opportunity to become an excellent NBA player.
And then my second question for both of you guys, for Dalton and Bronny. This organization has talked a lot about player development here over the last month or so. What are your expectations for yourselves starting with Summer League in terms of playing both in Sacramento and in Vegas, and kind of what you're hoping to gain between now and the start of the season?
I think it's going to be a lot of fun just getting out on the court with all the guys, and, you know, the first couple of days learning from JJ when he'll be there, and start the season, you know, go to the summer league and hopefully go win that, and then just go on and get the regular season started.
For me, probably just, you know, getting a feel for the game, especially at a next level. But just excited to go out there and compete with some, you know, great players, and being able to, you know, take this time to get ready for, you know, what's to come.
Dave McBenn with ESPN. Welcome to Dalton and Bronny. I want to start with JJ. Just in terms of like logistics here, who's going to be coaching the California Classic, and are your two rookies going to be playing up there and also in Vegas?
Yeah. So Dane Johnson will be coaching the California Classic and Summer League. I will be heavily involved in practices. I will also be involved in some capacity during the games, during film, all of that. You know, it's we talk about development. It's an incredible opportunity for Dane and his staff to develop further. For me, I have to sort of prioritize a bunch of different things right now, including building out a staff. but, you know, for both these guys, we expect them to play in both the California Classic and in Las Vegas.
And then just a question for both the rookies. Start with Dalton. How's it been from the moment, I guess, Wednesday till now? Like, what's the whirlwind been like for you?
To be honest, I have no clue. I'm just trying to just take it all in as much as I can and enjoy the moment. Meet all the guys, Rob and JJ, and then obviously I met Bronny, and just start meeting some teammates like Bron and AD and get to know those guys and learn from them.
And Bronny, you played 1 year at USC and then joined the team, you know, after the season already began. What about the timing to come into this year's draft compelled you to make that decision? And then how much of a consideration was, well, my father's still an active player?
For me, you know, I always try to put that narrative of me trying to get my name out for myself. But just coming in and trying to get better, you know, Rob has told me that there's a great development system here. So I just want to come in and get my work in and get better every day. But I never really had a thought of, you know, me going to play with my dad, but that's always, you know, there to, you know, take part of. But that wasn't a main focus of mine to do.
Hey, guys, over here. Jovan Buha with The Athletic. One question for each of you. Just entering the league as rookies, what area of your game are you looking to work on most coming in this summer?
For me, probably just creating my own shot. You know, I feel like I know how to play the game already and play the right way. But just being more aggressive on the offense end and creating my shot, because I know that's what I can do. So, yeah, just being more aggressive.
I'd say the same thing. Just go in, be aggressive, be ready to make some shots, and then just show my all-around game is one thing. Just show all around and be a complete player.
Kobe Bryce, Southern California News Group. Got one for both of you guys. Bronny first, kind of going off of what you just said. Because of the time you had to take off at USC, do you feel like there were parts of your game you weren't able to showcase as much because of that? And do you feel like, you know, once you're able to, I guess, get back on the court more consistently through summer league, you can, I guess, reestablish the offensive rhythm you may not have had at USC?
Yeah, for sure. The time that I had off, I feel like I could have been perfecting my game more. Yeah, I just feel like I've been given the opportunity to, you know, showcase what I can really do, because I wasn't given that much of an opportunity at SC. So, you know, I'm excited for what is to come.
And for you, Dalton, you kind of mentioned this, I think, in New York. You studied JJ while in college. JJ, Rob, you even mentioned that JJ was drawing up plays for Dalton right after you guys drafted him. Is there an added excitement or element of excitement just knowing that, you know, you'll be able to pick the brain of one of the, you know, best shooters that league has seen?
Yeah, for sure. Me and Coach Barnes, we watched a lot of J.J. Redick and how he comes off screens, gets openings, creating space even before he runs off the screen. So I'm excited just to learn from him and see how he sees the game.
Bill Plaschke, Los Angeles Times. This is for Bronny. How much more pressure is on you playing on a team with your father, and how are you going to handle that pressure?
It's for sure the amplified amount of pressure. I've already seen it, stuff, media and stuff on it, in the internet and stuff, talking about I might not deserve an opportunity. But, you know, I've been dealing with stuff like this for my whole life. So it's nothing different, but it's more amplified for sure. But I can get through it.
Hi, JJ. Mark Medina. Good to see you again. I understand this part might be fluid, but at least initially, what do you envision what that player development program will look like specifically for Dalton and Bronny?
Yeah, I think just in general, the player development program we're trying to build is holistic. I think oftentimes when people talk about player development, they talk about ball handling and shooting and passing, and certainly the mechanics of playing basketball are an important part of player development. But it's also tactical. It's about reads. It's about incorporating film, incorporating analytics. We will hopefully in the next few days or a couple weeks hire a director of player development program that sees my vision. It's nutrition. It's how you take care of your body, your work in the weight room. There's also, I think, a big part of player development, and it's for someone who has lived in this league a long time, a big part of this is the mental development and all the ups and downs that come. I had a chance to spend a few minutes with Dalton this morning, and one of the things we talked about is just being open-minded, having an openness and just letting go of outcomes. And the thing that excites me about both these guys is that their basic basketball is as workers. And that's a great starting point if you want to develop into a great NBA player. I'm not sure what's going on with my mic.
This is for Bronny, Darren Haynes, KCAL. You talked about writing your own story. And I heard your father, LeBron, talk about that as well. And we see him back here almost allowing you to have your own moment to write your own story. How would you describe your story right now?
To be honest, just living by the days, trying not to, care about whatever other people think about me, because there's a lot of people that, have something to say. But yeah, I'm just taking it by the day and staying sane while doing it.
Over here, Michael with NBCLA. For Dalton, and then one for Bronny quickly. For Dalton, as JJ said, they didn't think you'd be there at 17. A lot of people had you going top 10. Is that going to allow you to play with a chip on your shoulder? Have you already remembered the teams and the players that got drafted ahead of you? And for Bronny, now that you do know you're going to be teammates with your dad, how does your experience growing up, pickup games, all the videos we see you guys playing in the driveway, help you as you guys learn to play together?
I would say, of course, I know all the players and teams, but I'm just excited to be here in the right place, and I'm excited just to get to work here and go out and compete.
Yeah, for me, just building that foundation of playing the right way. Like I said, just being that guy to be coachable and play my role and, keep working while I'm doing it.
Bronny, David Pingelor, KTLA. Being around, obviously, the NBA and your dad, is the process going to be easier for you to get started, knowing what to expect and what you grew up around?
I had my own basketball stuff going on, so I wasn't really, in my dad's pocket all day, following him around the Lakers facility. But, yeah, I've had some stories, but I don't know what, exactly is to come.
So I have a question for each of you and then one for JJ. The numbers, got to ask you, Dalton, you wore number 3 all the way down, from high school all the way down. Now you got the nickname Connect 4. Did you come up with that name? And then also got to ask you, Bronny, number 9, when with the Lakers, everyone thinks of Nick the Quick, Nick Van Axel, but with you it was a Juice WRLD situation with you. You have 9 on the side of your ear too as well. Talk about that impact. And then JJ, for you, when you see their shooting ability, Bron and Austin Reeves and AD like running high splits, how do you see them fitting in situations like high splits and pin downs too as well?
I knew eventually, I probably would have to run into number 4, but 3's been my number my whole life, and then, 3, AD got it, so why not do Connect 4, why not?
Juice has just been a big part of, me keeping calm in some situations that I've been through. Just paying homage to him, especially because he passed, as a really important thing for me.
We're back. Yeah, I think you have to surround your best players with shooting in today's NBA. Spacing is at a premium. And as a coach, you know, there's a lot of plays that you don't have control of. It's over half the offensive possessions, right, are coming off a make or a miss. So it's important that you also have players that have a good feel for the game and can read and react. You know, we want to implement more structure, and with structure, you certainly need a high basketball IQ. But at times when there isn't structure and you don't have control, you also just have to have a feel for the game, and both these guys can shoot it, and they have good feel.
Rob, a question for you. You're feeling left out. We're a couple days into free agency, and I know you can't speak specifically about players because of the moratorium, but your roster, provided LeBron resigns, is full as it currently stands. How aggressively are you looking to create space to still improve this roster? And I guess if you could speak to some of maybe the roadblocks you guys have encountered here through the first 48 hours.
Yeah, I think we're going to always be aggressive to trying to make roster upgrades, and we'll be relentless to continue to look at what we can do. As you pointed out, we have 14 guys under guaranteed contract with one space. And this is the season of being mindful of all the different things we can approach to improve the roster. So we're in the midst of that as we speak. That'll continue in the coming days, and it often spills into, you know, Vegas, where all the GMs meet and gather and other deals get done. But yeah, we'll stay aggressive.
Rob, a follow that just on along the same lines, but you know, we've talked about, even at JJ's introductory press conference, but the future draft picks that you guys have available to trade. Is this a situation where we could be like in years past, where you continue to canvas things up to February, just knowing that you have that and just looking for ways to improve?
Yeah, I think if the right deal comes and we have to put in draft picks, we will. I think we've talked about it before. We're now in the apron world. We've seen, you know, contending teams or championship level teams have to lose players. That's a result of the apron world we're living in. So does it make trades more challenging? Yes. Does it make good trades impossible? No. So we'll continue to pursue upgrades to our roster.
Yeah, Dalton, one for you. We heard about the growth spurt that happened at a certain point in high school, but kind of the guard skills that you had built up. When did you start to feel like, combined with the height and go from junior college to Colorado and then eventually to Tennessee, when did you start to really think, yeah, hey, I could keep going up to that next level and that confidence grew?
I felt like I always had that ever since I touched the basketball. I knew that I could do it, just a matter of how. And, you know, my journey is not like everybody else's, but that's okay. Everybody else has a journey of their own. So just creating my path and, yeah, like I said, creating my path is something special, and a lot of kids will look up to it. So that's really cool to write my own story.
For sure. And then, Bronny, Rob had talked about looking at your game and kind of the point of attack defense and how that could really translate to the NBA level. How do you see that specifically with your game? How have you worked on that? And do you think you also can kind of size up, you know, defend 2-3 wing positions as well?
Yeah, I mean, other people see me as a big, kind of bigger guard. So I feel like I could take that role into guarding someone bigger. But yeah, just I've always taken pride in the defensive end, especially because it translates to, you know, better offensive looks. But yeah, I've trying to, yeah, been working on my defensive end, just because, you know, I'm not the biggest person. So yeah,
we did talk about that point of attack defense as something that we were drawn to, and something that Bronny and I talked about at the Chicago Combine is also being rim attack on offense. You know, I think he's shown the ability to space the floor, but we need downhill guards in our program that can put pressure on the paint. And we hope in, you know, the summer league, that's a skill that I know coach wants to develop. And Bronny is attacking the rim. I mean, he's as athletic as any guard, you know, in this draft. And so we'll develop him at both sides of the ball.